Hi, I was making one project for myself, and because I really liked the result, I decided to make a video so many other people can enjoy the same benefits. You can install, you can buy from eBay, actually really cheap, subwoofer from whatever car. I strongly recommend you this brand, Bose, and also I'm using small Bose amps. They came separately, but I'll tell you later about how they are connected. This one, the especially good thing is it plays really nice, soft and also strong wall frequencies, and in the same time there is no noise at all from the car, from plastics or from metals, like the annoying noise that you can hear usually from the really big and loud subwoofers. This plays really good quality, much better than anything else I've heard. Plus, it doesn't take any space. After I finish with the installation, this thing will be much better insulated and put somewhere here inside. And this one, also I'll put it somewhere here. It's important to notice this, the front, this mark shows the direction the subwoofer needs to be, because of the here is some exit of the air, I don't know exactly. The most interesting thing is this, you can connect to any stock multimedia without changing anything. For example, on this car, this Peugeot 208, year the model is 2014, from this player I cannot take from the back pre-out signal, like RCA exits for to go to another amp. So what actually I did and why I did it with these small things, amps, is they use a signal from that's already amplified by an amplifier, or like the ones that I'm using here is from the rear speakers. So actually what I did is I took the signal from the rear speakers, I took those small amps, they're all the same, they have five cables. The orange is plus 12 volts, the blue is remote, the black is zero, and the yellow and orange are signal. So what I did actually, that you can see, is the remote and the plus I connected together, because from this player I don't have a remote, but I took the plus from the lighter that I'm actually not using at all, and I checked that the lighter fuse is 30 amperes, which is more than enough. So what I did is I found this cable for the lighter, that it came here. So I didn't take a cable from there, but I connected, I took electricity straight from here, and as you can see I isolated it very well. So it goes through here, and it goes in the back. Also what I did is I opened this, and these two, the green and the brown cables, are the signal for my rear speaker. I opened this door cover, I found here, they are, as you can see, binded together. I found the green and the, I just want to see the cover, that's why I removed the door cover. I found the they're green and brown. So I found the wires here, as you can see, I cut them, I insulated the ones that are going to the speaker, so now the rear speakers are not working, but anyway I don't need them. And this is the cable that goes to the one amp. The other amp, because this subwoofer, it's from Mazda 6, they have one channel and two channel. The one channel usually comes with a small amp that you can use. And the two channel, it doesn't come with a small amp, it uses the big one that's under the seat, the passenger seat. On this side I did the same, I opened the rear door cover. I also found here the cables, actually they were different colors, but that's another thing also I was making, if you notice this, it's thermal insulation, like for pipes of ventilations they use it. I bought this. The noise reduction is really amazing, and I also put this on the inside of this whole panel, and the result was really good. If you can hear, I doubt you can hear on the video, but it's totally different noise when you close the doors, and when you're driving, the car is much more quiet. So let me tell you what I did and why I did it. I did it here because if let's say in 1-2 months or anytime I decide to remove the subwoofer and put back the old speakers, I don't need to remove the door covers again, like they're still removed. I need to finish the project. I want to make the video. I'll not remove the door covers. I'll just take out this plastic piece here, which happens for 20 seconds. I open here, I disconnect this cable that now it goes for the back, and I just connect the cables for the speakers, which I know which they are, for the rear speaker. I do this on this side and on the other side, and more or less in like 5 minutes, with only removing this plastic and on the other side there, I would have the rear speaker workings, and everything will be as in the factory. What else also I'm doing is, for example, if I want to, because this is the stock radio, as you can see, if I want to adjust the level of the subwoofer and I need more bass, more wall frequency, I'll just go to the settings, audio settings, and with the balance, I just go more to the rear, and this gives more signal to the rear speakers, which actually now is the subwoofer in the back. If I want less wall frequency, I just remove it to the front, and this balances. So you have, in this way, you also have control over the input of the subwoofer. The other thing that you can do is, if you don't use this, like my small amps, is you can connect signal, for example, from here, from the rear speakers. You can also leave them to work and use whine-in devices that they take the signal that's for a speaker and makes it, it reduces the voltage and makes it for a preamp. And then use a big external amp to give signal to the subwoofer. More or less, it was a big research what to do, but for me and for this car, I found that this works the best, because honestly, I finished the whole project. Okay, I have maybe half an hour more to close the door covers at this plastics, but in about hour and a half plus half an hour more that I have, in 2 hours, I completely changed the audio of my car. And later I will make a video to show, if it's possible to be heard with a phone, the difference with and without the subwoofer.